Let's start with traditional Prometheus deployment, either to a Kubernetes cluster or a standalone server in the same network where you have your applications. Prometheus uses different discovery mechanisms, such as DNS, Kubernetes API, cloud, and many others to discover targets. After Prometheus has found applications, it starts to scrape the metrics endpoint. Since it's a standalone deployment, it keeps all the metrics locally on the disk and in memory. That's one of the reasons why it's hard to scale Prometheus. You can only scale it vertically by increasing CPU, memory, or a disk size. Typically, you deploy alert manager that can send notifications based on the specified condition. For example, it can notify you if the CPU increased over a certain threshold. And of course, you have PromQL query language to query your data. And typically, you would use those queries in Grafana dashboard to visualize your metrics. Due to popularity and wide adoption of Prometheus, deployment models over time scaled beyond a single node. Projects like Cortex, Thanos, and many others started to leverage Prometheus to create large connected clusters with Prometheus as a base component, not counting that most cloud vendors nowadays have introduced managed services for Prometheus, such as Amazon Managed Prometheus, Google Cloud Managed Prometheus, Grafana Cloud, and more. This evolution of open source community led to the introduction of a new operational mode of running Prometheus called Agent. It is built directly into the Prometheus binary. The Agent mode disables some of the Prometheus usual features and optimizes the binary for scraping and remote writing to the remote locations. Introducing a mode that reduces the number of features enables new usage patterns. One of the features that the agent now allows is to create a global view. Most of the time, you would have many different clusters and environments in your infrastructure. You may have multiple Kubernetes clusters and different environments, such as development, staging, and production. With a traditional Prometheus deployment, you would need to deploy Grafana in each environment, which is not very convenient. Prometheus introduced three ways to support global view case, each with its own pros and cons. You have a federation. It allows a global level Prometheus server to scrape a subset of metrics from a live Prometheus. Prometheus remote read allows selecting raw metrics from a remote Prometheus server's database without a direct PromQL query. For example, Thanos used this approach. Unfortunately, there are cons too. Without features like query pushdown, in extreme cases, pulling gigabytes of compressed metrics data to answer a single query. And queries are very slow. Finally, we have Prometheus Remote Write, which seems to be the most popular choice nowadays. Prometheus Agent was built to support this use case. We will dive deeper in a minute, but first, let's distinguish between pushing metrics using PushGetaway and Remote Write. It's two completely different use cases. PushGetaway allows short-lived jobs, such as backup scripts, to push metrics to the Prometheus PushGetaway. It sort of works around when Prometheus cannot scrape the target directly. The standalone Prometheus instance scrapes the PushGetaway regularly, let's say every 15 seconds, as any other target. On the other hand, the remote write protocol is designed to make it possible to reliably propagate metrics in real time from a sender to a receiver without loss. It allows us to forward all or a subset of metrics collected by Prometheus to the remote location. While the official Prometheus Remote Write API specification is in review stage, the ecosystem adopted the Remote Write protocol as the default metrics export protocol. For example, Cortex, Thanos, OpenTelemetry, and cloud services like Amazon, Google, Grafana, Logs.io, etc. all support ingesting data via Remote Write. Streaming data from such a scraper enables global view use cases by allowing you to store metrics data in a centralized location. You can use agent mode by enabling using a feature flag. The agent mode optimizes Prometheus for the remote write use case. It disables querying, alerting, and local storage and replaces it with a customized TSDB wall write ahead logging. That means Prometheus doesn't need to build chunks of data in memory and no more unkilled errors in your Kubernetes cluster. Everything else stays the same: scraping logic, service discovery, and related configuration. It can be used as a drop-in replacement for Prometheus if you want to just forward your data to a remote Prometheus server or any other remote write compliant project. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.